Greetings everyone, Adventures Infinity here with a small tutorial regarding XCOM 2 and the Steam Workshop. Now, Firaxis added official Steam Workshop support to XCOM 2, and that means very easy modding. The game is also very open to modding. I've already adjusted INI files myself to a lesser degree, and I'm no programmer. But this is a fantastic change, and I wanted to quick go over the process you would go through to do that. You just open up Steam in your library here, and go down to Browse the Workshop. This is the first time I had used it, and it's already fantastic. The biggest thing people have added is a lot of cosmetic accessories, such as Cap'n Bub's Accessories Pack, adding in berets, and now I guess a headset with mic and baseball cap. It's awesome. And getting a mod is as easy as finding one you like and subscribing. It'll immediately download and install into the game. It is rather fantastic. Now, a couple that I want to highlight are a few mods from the Long War development team. And those are the fellows that made the Long War mod for the first game, adding new layers of depth for the XCOM Enemy Unknown and Enemy Within, which include the Muton Centurion Alien Pack adds Muton Centurions to the game as an enemy that you might encounter. Has that ability Warcry from the first game. And after finding this, you can just simply go to the link up here, Long War Studios Workshop. And you see there are other ones. Leader Pack allows a soldier to also be a leader for the game, add some extra mechanics. And the SMG Pack, adding submachine guns to the game, which grants additional mobility at the cost of damage. Already some really great mods, and I've already downloaded a ton having to do with customization options, like custom face paints, there was one that was an extra tattoo, Jack tattoos, I got that one. So, once you have all these mods, you simply go to your game, press play. You'll get the initial starter screen for XCOM 2, where you can load up all your mods. And you can just add in a mod, whether you want to have playing or not, one by one, and play and bring the mods in. And so, we now go to Miss Eric's character here, to Hats. You can already see mods that I've brought in. The Field Beret from Cap'n Bub, thank you. And that's it. One thing to note is that if you use a certain mod pack in your game and then you load or create a new game, then the game will then be dependent on that mod. So if you turn that mod off later, you won't be able to load the game. Just something to keep in mind. Just think of it as you can put a mod into a save game, but you can't take it out. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed or found it useful. Until the next video, this is Adventures Infinity signing out. Take it easy.